So we're well into the dark now. I don't know how to change this iPhone 11 Pro to not absorb so much light, but here's the autopilot. You can see...
OpenPilot.
Dang it! I'm an airline pilot. I don't know. OpenPilot, autopilot, it's awesome.
It's the common deal.
But you can see it has these markings that trace the lines. On the left, that's the dash line. This is two lanes of travel going this direction. And then the gray line in the middle is where the car is going to track. And it is dark outside. It's tracking incredibly well. We're going 70 around this nice big gradual turn. Jared's over here just kicking back.
Watch it, ready to take over.
Let me lighten it up. Now it's filming in the dark.
Dang it.
I don't know how to run this thing. But that's amazing. Pretty crazy. This is what's amazing to me.
Yeah, see how those two. I bet those are just little infrared lights.
Yeah.
So it's insane.
About 2 hours worth of driving and it didn't kill us. That's fantastic.
We're getting close. We're only about, it says 30 minutes away from home. I don't believe quite that much. It's a little less than that, probably.
Nice. All right, this is the first freeway on ramp. We're on the west 30. We're getting on the 15 north. We're gonna see how it does when it merges and has to pick a lane.
Turn slight right onto I-15 north. See, is it there yet? Oh, wait a minute. Oh, there it is. All right. Let's see what it does here. Oh, it did it. I didn't even touch it.
That is awesome.
I didn't even touch it.
Now it's hitting the brakes to follow that dude that's super slow.
Yep, and I'm going to bump up the cruise to 75 or 80. There it is. I'm just going to wait to follow him.
So I wonder if we didn't have the blinker on, if it would have gone straight.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it would have.
That is amazing.
Yeah. All right, so let's see here. And I'll put my blinker on here and just let it...
Continue on current road for about 23 miles.
Just a regular lane change.
There goes, isn't it? Cruise control kicked on. So I didn't touch the brake or the gas on any of that. It's all just adaptive cruise control. Here comes the lane change back. And straight back out.
So amazing. Wow.
Pretty cool.
Amazing thing is the lane changes with this open pilot. With the regular car lane control, you hit the blinker and then everything turns off and you have to manually change lanes and re-engage. The open pilot intercepts the turn, you force it over the line, it intercepts the turn and re-straightens, realigns in the lane.
You actually don't even force it over the lane, all you gotta do is nudge the steering wheel.
Just nudge the wheel.
Yeah, nudge the steering wheel.
Straight away, just passing a semi.
It's a pretty good turn right up there where those cars are ahead.
Man, I should have brought my gimbal for this.
Yeah. Next time.
Next time.
Here's the turn coming up right here. It's a pretty sharp turn, actually.
And we're going to 80.
Yeah, we're doing 80, so that's why it's a pretty sharp turn.
It's like a non-issue for it. That is amazing.
And even in the left lane, even so, the tighter of the two. No,
autopilot. Okay, so up here there's a merge on ramp. So the right hand side lines are disappearing. And it's smooth as butter. You can see how it re-picked it up right there. I should have filmed up there, my bad.
There'll be another one here. The wait station is right here. So here another quarter mile or so. Or three quarters of a mile. That'd be a good turn down here at the Port of Gap as well. Over the highway drive assist feature of this car.
What do you mean?
So there's a feature only on the limited version of this car that does a highway only, freeway only, and it does help with the driving, but since it's doing all the driving, that's probably why I took it over. But one of the things that it does is it does it'll auto change the speed if the speed limit changes, and it is not doing that.
Oh, really?
So lost one feature.
So the car has a GPS and a database that tells you the
speed limit. Yep, so it uses the navigation, so it uses speed limit.
On the right.
And so,
really?
And it took over that highway drive assist feature of auto speed limit change.
Wow.
So
that's
one,
pretty high tech,
one
really.
One feature that's lost. So, but that's only in this the highest model of this car.
Gotcha. So,
trim model of the limited. So, all right, so we're going to see if this is going to take the turn. That one's a right turn only lane, the right one, so I'm not going to get in that one, but I'm going to wait up here and I'll turn on the blinker and see if it pulls over. It does have the navigation set up, so it theoretically might do it. We'll see here in just a second though. And I'm not going to pull on it just because I don't want it to go in that lane. So I am going to pull over, and let's see here, this double lane, it didn't catch that,
bummer.
But it might have been just because that second lane over there on the right.
Yeah, that's a weird
one. I'm not sure, but.
It's kind of fun stuff. We'll mess around with that in the daylight tomorrow, huh?
Yep.
So awesome.
Killed it. All right, here's a good one right here. This road bends just a little bit. We'll see what it does here. I'm sure it'll do good.
Man, it's crazy how bad the filming is at night. Daytime, it doesn't look that bumpy, but nighttime, you can see every little jolt.
Yeah. Hopefully the stabilization is...
Turn right onto El Rancho Boulevard and then turn right.
Tracking that, dude. That is awesome. Wow.
Yeah, see what this is called.
It's like, nobody in front of me. I'm going.
Lane lines up here. There will be for a minute. But I'm gonna turn it down to 25.
So we just have single lane lines now, and it seems to do pretty well with that.
Yeah, it's falling pretty close, allowing people to still park. On that side over there.